Hello friends, now today we are going to discuss about hydropower plant, that is hydroelectric power plant, or it may be called as hydel power plant. The hydropower plant playing a very important, a very crucial role in the development of a country, as it provides power at cheapest rate, being perpetual source of energy. Nearly 20% of total world power is generated using hydropower plants. There are some fortunate countries in the world where 90% of the nation's power requirement is met by hydropower. There are few countries like Russia and Nepal where vast hydro resources are yet to be harnessed. As per the estimate of World Power Organization, the world hydro potential is roughly 5000 gigawatt, whereas only 200 gigawatt is presently developed, that is 4% only. Many more hydropower plants are including incoming plants of the government of India. Rain falling upon the earth's surface has a potential energy relative to the oceans towards which it flows. Now the current scenario of hydraulic source, that is the water source in India, we are having around 1675 million meter cube of flow rate, out of which 60% water we are getting from Ganga, Brahmaputra and Indus rivers, and 16% from Narmada, Tapi and Mahanadi. Now next and most important part is hydropower cycle, or it is called as hydrological cycle. The science which deals with rainfall and runoff is called as hydrology. The evaporation of water from the surface of river and oceans and its precipitation on the earth is known as hydrological cycle. The distribution of precipitation on the earth's surface and beneath the earth is calculated with help of hydrological considerations. The water is evaporated from plants, rivers, oceans and carried with the air in form of vapor, which is known as clouds. When the water vapors in the atmosphere are cooled below dew point temperature, it falls in form of the water or snow depending upon the atmospheric temperature. This evaporation and precipitation is natural continuous process and therefore constitutes a presential source of energy. Processes of evaporation and precipitation are shown in figure. Most of the water resource projects are multi-purpose projects, as irrigation, navigation, flood control and generation of electrical power. The problem in the design of multi-purpose project usually are how much water is needed and how much is available. There are many difficult problems to answer because it involves social, economic and engineering aspects. The design of project, whether it is multi-purpose or single purpose, depends on the availability of water. Many projects are designed to control flood, irrigation and power generation if the quantity of water is available is sufficient for the required purpose and the site is as per requirement. Many projects are designed only for the irrigation purpose or power generation purpose. Now next is current energy scenario in India. The purpose of this chapter is to introduce the readers with different types of hydroelectric power plants and make them conversant with various components of the power plant and their functions. Now, India's total economic hydropower potential has been assessed as 84,000 megawatt at 60% of the load factor, which corresponds to 160,000 megawatt installed capacity. The potential developed power so far is only 14%, and another 7% is under development. Thus, about 79% potential is still to be harnessed. Power is very important infrastructure for overall development of the country, because it is a tool change or tool to forge the economic growth of a country. Therefore, there has been ever increasing need for more and more power in all countries in the world. The developing countries of the world are now experiencing energy crisis and are planning to find out the method and devices to explore various possibilities of energy generation to meet the growing demand. So, an every increase in the head for the given output reduces the quantity of water to be stored and therefore the capital cost. In order to find out the most effective and economical head, it is necessary to consider all possible factors which may affect it. Next is groundwater data. So groundwater data, it is nothing but underground movement for the stability, also prevents the leakages. Now the current scenario of land. Next is geological investigations. The geological investigation of reservoir area includes investigations concerning possible leakages from basin and submergence of mineral deposits, certain structural features like faults, shear zones, and bedding planes may allow free passage to water, and therefore their nature and distribution deserve careful study. Geological investigation of dam site and appurtenant structures. The dam is very costly structure in hydropower plants. Its safety is most important, as its failure causes heavy economical loss as well as loss of life and property caused by the sudden release of impounded water. So, therefore, the geological investigation of the dam site involves close study of soil and rock present in the foundation area, all possible three-dimensional information of the rock directly below the dam foundation, as well as little upstream and downstream is necessary. So factor affecting on the geological investigations are tide basin of ample size. The more number of valleys and hills will be giving us the more amount of runoff. Next is the narrow outlet to reduce the material required to construct the dam. Strong foundation is important for the earth prone zone, that is where we are getting maximum earthquake. Okay, so in that case we can utilize this strong foundation. Fourth one is the space for spillways, where we can bypass the water to the tailrace. And the most important thing, confiscate water should not submerge valuable minerals and agricultural land. And the last is availability of raw material for the dam construction. Now, consideration of water pollution effect. The effect of polluted water on the power plant is one of the major consideration in the selection of hydroelectric power plant site. In some hydroelectric installations, certain peculiar effect as presence of foul smelling gases in station and vicinity, corrosion of metallic structures and electrical equipments, and overheating of the machine part may have been noticed immediately after commissioning the stations. Now we'll see the causes for deterioration of water and its effect on the power plant are listed below. The water gets polluted if area submerged under the water contains mineral deposit of harmful nature. The presence of sulfate from H2S under the action of microorganisms and presence of alkaline and acidic deposits largely increase the corrosive properties of water. Submerged vegetation is one of the main causes of water pollution. The considerable amount of twigs, leaves, logs, etc. underwater are allowed to decay and badly smelling gases are generated. In large reservoir, wind velocity may not be high enough to mix up with warm water at the top of the cold dense water at the bottom. There is also depletion of dissolved oxygen in the lower strata due to the chemical composition of organic matter. This depletion of oxygen and thermal stratification in the lower strata generates harmful gases such as carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfide and methane, which pollutes the water. Now we'll see the adverse effect of water pollution. The adverse effect of polluted water involve damage of dam structure and fittings, damage to the electrical machineries and health hazards to operating personnel. The water containing hydrogen sulfide, carbon dioxide, methane, etc. is highly corrosive to the dam and concrete structures. The H2SO4 formed by oxidation of H2S attacks the cement constituents and disintegrate the concrete. The presence of above mentioned gases leads to an increase in solubility of insoluble soil and rock constituents. Serious damage to the dam has been reported in Norway, whether water from the mountain stream is highly polluted. Structures, metallic pipings and penstock are also affected by the corrosive gases like H2S and CH4. The actions are rapid in humid atmosphere, which is common in hydroelectric power plant. The health hazards are generally headache, dizziness, that is giddiness, dryness of nose, throat and chest pains are the effects of H2S. The high concentration, that is less than 300 ppm of H2S, even causes paralysis. It is not advisable to select the site for power plant where the action of polluted water on machine part is severe and there are more chances of health hazards. Next point is sedimentation effect. The sedimentation of reservoir is important from two point of view. sedimentation robs the capacity of the reservoir and it further causes the rapid erosion of the turbine blades. The impact caused by natural phenomenon of sedimentation must be carefully considered in the selection of hydroelectric generation site. It is always necessary to estimate the life of the plant on the basis of sedimentation collected in the reservoir as capacity of the plant is reduced by sedimentation per year. If the sedimentation collection is sufficiently large, the plant life is comparatively small on the basis of this. It is not worthwhile to select such site for hydroelectric plant. Next is the environmental aspects. In addition to being efficient and economical for its intended purpose, the project should be designed on the basis of the best available information so as to first is minimize the impact of the project, second to enhance the local environment, and third be in the best public interest. Environmental and engineering discipline must work together in site selection process. If the mutual interrelation between engineering and environmental conditions are recognized at the beginning of the planning stage, the final design can be developed that both compatible with the local environment and efficient for its intended function. The site selection should fulfill all the following requirements. Those are, first, to assure safe, healthful, productive and culturally pleasing surroundings. Second, to avoid health hazards or other undesirable and unintended consequences. Third, to preserve important historical, cultural, natural aspects of the site. The potential impact of a water power, this power plant, on existing land resources is depend on the specific site consideration. In addition to the surface and subsurface geological investigation, the site feasibility study should also include determination of important characteristic of the area, including the topography, history, geography, ecology, and land use. Now next is construction and operation components of hydroelectric power plant. First is reservoir. The natural stream of water, if used for hydroelectric project, may be unable to satisfy the demands of its consumer during extremely low flows. The quantity of water flows is extremely large during flood period, whereas the quantity of water flow is very little during the dry periods of the year, as mentioned earlier. Now, two basic functions of reservoirs, and those are, first is the storage and second is to satisfy the customer's demand. Increase in the dam height produces increase in the head and main output. The gain in main output requires an economic analysis because gain in output must counterbalance the increase in the cost due to increased height. If the head of power plant is solely created by the dam, then it may be permitting the increase in height to increase in installed capacity. The economic analysis of storage possibilities is not rigid, and therefore the designer must take his own analysis of storage, cost balancing and cost increase in dam height against the advantage gained from extra firm output. Now next is types of reservoir. Here you can see the reservoir which is in valleys, where the valley sides are acting as a natural wall. So the cost of construction is considerably reduced in this type of valleys. Next, bankside reservoir. The London water supply system is one of the best example of use of bankside storage. The water is taken from the River Thames and River Lee. Basically, the bankside reservoir may be built to serve and store the water. The water stored in such reservoir may stay there for several months, during which time normal biological process may substantially reduce many contaminants in that. Here you can see the image of bankside reservoir. Now next is construction and operation components of hydro. Now next and most important part is dam. The dam is the most important and expensive structure in hydroelectric power plant. The dam can be constructed in several different forms with different materials. The most suitable type of particular site will be depend on large number of factors as topographical, geological, availability of a material, labor cost and many others. So dam is a solid barrier constructed at a suitable location across river valley to store flowing water. The storage of flowing water can be utilized for following objectives. First is to generate an electricity, that is hydropower. Second is for irrigation, that is catering the water or supplying the water to the irrigation for the agriculture and crop. Third is water for domestic consumption, that is for households and industries. Fourth one is drought and flood control. During the worst dry period, we can utilize the water which is stored in the dam, that is called as the drought period. And third is the flood control, by means of which we can control the flood. Next is for navigational facilities, and last is other additional utilization is to develop fisheries. So these are the important objectives of storing the water. Now next is terminology. We will discuss terminology later. We'll see the types of dam. In that we will see first based on structural behavior. Here you can see the gravity dam, arch dam, buttress dam and embankment dam. These four are major types of dams. We can generally visit to any power plant or any dam, any reservoir. Out of these four we can see different things. Now next and most important part is hydropower cycle, or it is called as hydrological cycle. The science which deals with rainfall and runoff is called as hydrology. The evaporation of water from the surface of river and oceans and its precipitation on the earth is known as hydrological cycle. The distribution of precipitation on the earth's surface and beneath the earth is calculated with help of hydrological considerations. The water is evaporated from plants, rivers, oceans and carried with the air in form of vapor, which is known as clouds. When the water vapors in the atmosphere are cooled below dew point temperature, it falls in form of the water or snow depending upon the atmospheric temperature. This evaporation, and see, in India the Bhakra dam is the highest concrete gravity dam in Asia and the second highest in the world. You can just imagine. It is developed and constructed against River Satluj in Himachal Pradesh. And this construction, total time required to construct this dam was around 15 years. It was started in 1948 and completed in 1963. So it took total 15 years to. Its height is around 740 feet. You can just imagine, the height of Bhakra Nangal Dam is around 740 feet from the deepest foundation to the crest, which is more than three times of Qutub Minar, which is located in Hyderabad. Next is buttress dam. The dam of buttress type have become more and more popular because the overall economy in their construction. They are suitable for weaker foundations where differential statements and settlements are likely to occur. They are also more safe against earthquake effects. They have been built in very large number in Italy and Japan. In Japan, in spite of high seismic activity and limited river potential, hundreds of dams of various design are being built. And the arrangement of the dam you can see in the figure on the image. This is a cross-sectional view, that is the side view, as well as top view, that is the plan view. Next and last type of dam is earth fill or embankment dam. The earth dams have more and more popular in recent years owing to the development in soil mechanics and heavy earth moving machineries. The earth dams are more economical for sites where excavation of the foundation soil is considerable. A safe earth dam can be built for amongst any given site of foundation condition by utilizing a wide range of earth material like loose rock, gravel, sands, silt, rock, floor and clay. Actually, in the interest of economy, the design of an earthen dam should be adopted for the utilization of material available at near the site. It can be built on weak or previous foundations where the use of other dam would be impracticable. The special feature of earth dam which permit its adoption are the ability of plastic earth fill to deform without rupture, and secondly, large base width which reduces the shear stresses in the foundation. Now you can see the image of earth fill or embankment, this type of valleys. Next, bankside reservoir. The London water supply system is one of the best example of use of bankside storage. The water is taken from the River Thames and River Lee. Basically, the bankside reservoir may be built to serve and store the water. The water stored in such reservoir may stay there for several months. Now first see impulse turbine. It operates on high velocity where the pressure is considerably reduced in the conversion type of nozzle. So first you can see the cross flow type of turbine. It is again divided into two types. First is the horizontal inlet and second is the vertical inlet. You can see in the first figure, that is in a horizontal inlet, the water from the penstock is coming through the nozzle, and there is a dodge which circulates this water to the turbine in two different passes. First pass is coming from outer periphery to inside, second is inside to the outside. Second is the vertical one, so the direction of the feeding of this water is totally changed. It is now in vertical direction. You can see the image of this cross flow turbine. It is of cylindrical shape. Here you can see the shape is cylindrical. These are the nozzles in that. So Pelter turbine, we are aware about this turbine, and we have also studied this Pelton turbine in fluid mechanics. So this is the penstock where we are getting the water, okay. Second is the sphere, or it is called as the needle wall, to control the flow rate of the water through the nozzle. Third is the water nozzle where we are getting the water actually. Fourth is the needle wall, that is kind of sphere, okay. Fifth is the turbine bucket. Here you can see that this is just see this image which is located near, okay. In this image we can see the shape of turbine, that is called as the bucket. And fifth is the case, that is called as the housings. So whenever water will come through the penstock, it will be directly fetching towards the turbine blades through the nozzle. But we can control the rate of flow to the turbine by means of the sphere, by adjusting it. So it is totally hydraulic based. Pelton wheel turbine is again classified into three types. First is the single nozzle. First figure shows the single nozzle. Second figure shows a two nozzle type. And third is multi nozzle type. So in multi nozzle, we are getting the maximum amount of this type of valleys. Next, bankside reservoir. The London water supply system is one of the best example of use of bankside storage. The water is taken from the River Thames and River Lee. Basically, the bankside reservoir may be built to serve and store the water. The water stored in such reservoir may stay there for several months, during which time normal biological process may substantially reduce many contaminants. Now, consideration of water pollution effect. The effect of polluted water on the power plant is one of the major consideration in the selection. You can see the runner blades are adjustable. These blades are adjustable, so we can vary its width. It is pure axial flow turbine, uses basic airfoil theory. The Kaplan's blades are adjustable for the pitch and will handle great variation of flow very efficiently. They are 90% or better in efficiency and are used in place some of the odd but great Francis type in good many installation. They are very expensive. The most important thing, and this is called as the cons of this turbine, is it is not cost effective. The Kaplan turbine, unlike all other turbines, the runner blades are movable. The application of Kaplan turbine are from head of 2 meter to 40 meter. These turbine are constructed to run at speed varying from 60 to 220 RPM. The work under varying head from 2 to 60 meters. These are particularly suitable for variable heads and for variable flows and where the ample quantity of water is available. The specific speed of a Kaplan lies in the range of 400 to 1500, so that the speed of rotor is much higher than that of Francis turbine for the same output, and the head of Kaplan turbine having the same size of Francis develops more power under the same head and flow continuity. The great strides are made in the last few decades to improve the performance of propeller turbine part of load conditions. Next is a spillway. Spillway is generally we are providing as a part of dam, okay, wherein it is used to provide a controlled release of flow from the dam or levee into the downstream area. It is also called as overflow channel. It releases the water during flood. It also acts as safety valve. The spillway is used to discharge the water during flood period without passing through the powerhouse. That means it acts as a safety valve for the dam. Now, certain types of spillway that we are going to study later.